Hello all. Now let's discuss about other mycobacterial infections like leprosy and other miscellaneous mycobacterias. Okay, so let's start with the first one, that is leprosy. Then we will come to other mycobacterial infections. Now leprosy, it is also known as Hansen's disease. Okay, it is also known as Hansen's disease. And it is caused by a bacteria known as Mycobacterium leprae. Okay, Mycobacterium leprae. Now, what is the treatment of leprosy? The treatment of leprosy is known as MDT therapy. The treatment of leprosy is known as MDT. MDT stands for multi drug therapy. Okay, multi drug therapy. Now let's see what are the drugs and what is this MDT therapy. So let's see first classification of leprosy, what are the different types of leprosy and what are the different types of drugs or MDT we give. Okay, classification of leprosy. The classification we follow for the treatment of leprosy in India and all over the world, we follow WHO classification. Okay, you follow WHO classification of leprosy. Now WHO has classified leprosy into three types. Okay, three types. The first one is known as single lesion posse bacillary. Posse means few bacilli will be there. The first leprosy type is single lesion posse bacillary leprosy. Then we have only posse bacillary leprosy, and lastly we have multi bacillary leprosy. Okay, so in multi bacillary leprosy, can we say the patient will be having various very large amount of bacterias. Okay, so here the patient has very large amount of bacteria. Sometimes it is known as lepromatous type, lepromatous leprosy. When you do microscopy and see the immunity status, it can be called as lepromatous leprosy. Now on what basis we have classified? We have classified these three types of leprosy on the basis of skin lesion in which the patient will come to us. Okay, now what are the skin lesion in leprosy? The skin lesion are generally hypopigmented. Okay, hypopigmented or reddish macules on skin. Macules are the flat lesions on skin. Now in case of single lesion posse bacillary, there is only one skin lesion. There is only one skin lesion. How many skin lesions are there? Only one in case of single lesion posse bacillary. Only one. Now in case of posse bacillary, you will write there are 2 to 5 skin lesions in posse bacillary, 2 to 5 skin lesion, and in multi bacillary at least 6 or more than 6 skin lesions are there. Okay, at least 6 or more than 6 skin lesions are there. Now this is the main criteria of classifying leprosy. But remember, we also see, which is not a mandatory criteria, we also see nerve involvement. The nerve become thickened and the nerve become damaged. Okay, in posse bacillary there is no nerve involvement or zero nerve involvement. There is only single skin lesion. In posse bacillary either no or one nerve involvement is there. In multi bacillary at least 2 or more than 2 nerve involvements are there. Okay, now why we have divided them into three? Because the treatment of all these three leprosy is different. Okay, they all these three leprosy, which is single lesion posse bacillary, simple posse bacillary or multi bacillary, they have different treatment. So let's see first what is the treatment of single lesion posse bacillary. So let's see the treatment of single lesion posse bacillary. Posse bacillary. Now, the treatment of single lesion possibacillary is Rome therapy. Okay, what is there? Rome therapy. Now, Rome stands for, you will write, rifampicin, ofloxacin, and minocycline. Minocycline is a tetracycline group of antibiotic. Okay, minocycline. So this stands for Rome therapy. Okay, now how much dose we generally give? Remember, we give 600 milligram of rifampicin, 400 milligram of ofloxacin, and 100 milligram of minocycline as a single dose. So only one dose is given. This will treat leprosy. Okay, single lesion possibacillary. So the treatment is single dose of Rome therapy. Now the point you have to remember in Rome therapy, remember this Rome therapy is contraindicated in pregnancy, because fluoroquinolones and tetracyclines, they are unsafe in pregnancy. They are also contraindicated in children less than 5 years of age. Children less than 5 years of age. Now remember, you just have to remember one point, that in children of age 5 to 14 years, reduce the dose of these drugs to half. Give half dose of these drugs in children from 5 to 14 years. More than 14 years, this is the dose of the drug we will give. Okay, in children 5 to 14 years, we will give half of the dose. We will be giving in children 300, 200, and 50 milligram. Okay, so this is the treatment of single lesion possibacillary. Now let's see the treatment of possibacillary leprosy and multibacillary leprosy. Okay, so simply possibacillary and multibacillary leprosy. Now in possibacillary, remember, we give two drugs for 6 months, and in multibacillary we give three drugs for 12 months. Okay, we give three drugs for 12 months. So can we say that we have fixed the duration of treatment? When we are giving the treatment for fixed duration, it is known as fixed duration therapy. It is known as fixed duration therapy. Okay, now let's see what are these two drugs we generally give. The two drugs we generally give for 6 months is rifampicin and the second drug you will write is Dapsone. Okay, now rifampicin is given in possibacillary as well as multibacillary both. Dapsone is also given in possibacillary and multibacillary. Now there is a drug which is given only in multibacillary. The third drug which is given only in multibacillary but not in possibacillary is clofazimine. So clofazimine is given only in multibacillary leprosy as a third drug. Okay, as a third drug. Now you will write the dose of these drugs. Now rifampicin is given as a dose of 600 milligram in both cases, 600 milligram once a month. But this drug you will be giving under your supervision. The patient will be eating this drug in front of you, supervised. Okay, Dapsone you will write 100 milligram daily, and this 100 milligram daily the patient will eat at his or her home. So you will write unsupervised. That patient will not eat in front of you, unsupervised Dapsone in both cases. But here we will be giving for 6 months in multibacillary. In posse we will be giving for 6 months. In Dapsone, in multibacillary, these two drugs are given for 12 months. Now, what about clofazimine? It's very easy to remember about clofazimine. Clofazimine, make the dose of the rifampicin and Dapsone half. Rifampicin was given 600 mg once a month supervised. You will write clofazimine is given 300 mg once a month supervised. And 50 milligram daily unsupervised. So clofazimine is given by both method. So can we say the only drug which is not given under supervision is Dapsone? Dapsone is the only drug which is not given under supervision. Now this is the dose of the drugs which we have written. Is the dose for a person who weighs, it is the dose of a person who weighs generally, this dose which we have written of rifampicin, Dapsone and clofazimine, for a person who weighs for 50 to 70 kg. So the dose is 600 milligram once a month, 100 milligram daily, and clofazimine is given both 300 milligram once a month supervised and 50 milligram daily. Okay, daily. So this is the dose which we have written is for a 60 to 70 kg person. Okay, now you will write for children for age group of 10 to 14 years, and for the children of the age group less than 10 years, the dose might differ. Okay, the dose might differ. In children for the age of 10 to 14 years, the dose of rifampicin is 450 milligram. Okay, make it 3/4. Here make it half, 50 milligram. And again, clofazimine you will write once a month, make it half, 150 milligram. And 50 milligram every alternative day. Every alternative day. Okay, now in children less than 10 years of age, you will write the dose of rifampicin is 300 milligram. Dapsone 25 milligram, okay, and clofazimine you will write 100 milligram, and 50 milligram you'll write twice a week, two times a week. Okay, so this is the treatment of and the dose of these drugs in leprosy. Now, what are the other drugs we have in leprosy? You will write, apart from rifampicin, Dapsone and clofazimine, which is now considered as the first line drug, what are the other drugs we have for leprosy? So you can write one mnemonic for other drugs. These drugs are COMECUM. So apart from these drugs, you will write the drug is clarithromycin. Or you can also use azithromycin, ofloxacin, which was given in Rome therapy, and minocycline was also given in Rome therapy, and anti-tubercular drug ethambutol. These are the second line drugs. So they are generally not given in WHO regimen, but these drugs are also found to be effective in cases of leprosy. Okay, now remember, which of the following drugs among all of them are lepricidal? Which of the following drug is lepricidal? You'll write the two drugs are lepricidal. The first is rifampicin and second is ofloxacin. So these two drugs are lepricidal. Rest other drugs are generally lepristatic. Okay, lepristatic drugs. Okay, so rifampicin and ofloxacin is lepricidal, and you will write that rifampicin, it is the most effective drug we have for leprosy. Rifampicin is the most effective drug we have for leprosy, and there is one great advantage of using rifampicin. Earlier, before the invention of rifampicin, we were giving only Dapsone to our patient. Now we always give we never give dapsone alone. We always give rifampicin along with dapsone. The reason is this rifampicin, it also reduce the emergence of resistance to dapsone. Of dapsone, so it prevent dapsone resistance in leprosy also. Okay, so it is always given with dapsone. Always with dapsone. We nowadays don't use dapsone as a single drug. Okay, so it will inhibit the occurrence of resistance against dapsone in cases of leprosy bacteria, and it is also the most effective drug we have in leprosy. Okay. Now, let's talk about these drugs individually. Before that, let's talk about there is one reaction known as lepra reaction. Then we will discuss about these drugs individually. Lepra reactions. Now, lepra reaction, if you talk about, lepra reactions are the hypersensitivity or allergic reaction. It occurs due to MDT therapy, that means drugs for leprosy. When we give, patient undergoes various allergic disease, and remember, it is more common in multibacillary leprosy. Multibacillary leprosy, or you can write lepromatous leprosy. When the bacterial load in a patient is very high. Okay. Now these lepra reactions, they are divided into two. Okay. The first is known as type 1 lepra reaction. Type 1 lepra reaction. Second, we name it as type 2 lepra reaction. Okay. Now, type 1 lepra reaction, it is also known as reversal reaction. It is known as reversal reaction. And type 2 lepra reaction in severe cases is known as ENL. In severe cases, it is known as ENL. ENL stands for arrhythmia, nodosum, leprosum. Okay, it is also known as arrhythmia, nodosum, leprosum. Now let's see, what does it mean? Okay, what do we mean by this 1 and 2 lepra reaction? Now remember, what happens in type 1 lepra reaction? When the patient of lepromatous leprosy comes and you start MDT, that is drug for leprosy, the patient immunity improves. The cell-mediated immunity of the patient improves. Because of this reason, this immunity will go and kill this leprosy bacteria. And when the immunity of the leprosy of a patient improves, it is known as TT type. LL stand for lepromatous leprosy. TT stand for tubercular type. So suddenly this cell-mediated immunity will improve. And the leprosy bacteria, which is at the skin or at the nerve, this immunity will go and kill those skin lesion and nerve lesion. So patient may have nerve damage also. So as you are saying that cell mediated immunity is improving, remember, it is which type of hypersensitivity? It is type 4 hypersensitivity. Okay, or delayed type of hypersensitivity. It is also known as type 4 hypersensitivity. Type 1 lepra reaction is type 4 hypersensitivity. Now, what is type 2 lepra reaction? In type 2 lepra reaction, it only exclusively occurs in multibacillary leprosy. When you give MDT, what happens? The antigens, MDT, multidrug therapy, will kill leprosy bacteria, and the antigens of leprosy will come into the blood. When antigen of the leprosy will come into the blood, the antibody will be formed against them. And this antigen antibody complex will deposit in various organ, and it will cause multi-organ damage. Okay, and it is multi organ damage, and the patient will have constitutional symptoms like fever, joint pain, etc. So it is the more dangerous type. ENL is even more dangerous. Okay, now this type of leprosy reaction hypersensitivity is known as type 3 hypersensitivity, or arthrous reaction, or antigen antibody complex mediated reaction. So it is which type of hypersensitivity? Type 3. So how to remember? Type 1 lepra reaction is type 4 hypersensitivity. Okay, and type 2 lepra reaction is type 3 hypersensitivity. 2 is 3, 1 is 4. Okay, now for any hypersensitive reaction, let's see what is the treatment. The treatment of both cases is somewhat same. In mild cases of lepra reaction, you can give NSAIDs like aspirin to control this inflammation, or paracetamol in mild cases. Now earlier we used to give a drug chloroquine also, because chloroquine has anti-inflammatory or immunosuppressive property. Okay, it has anti-inflammatory property. But now remember, for severe case and overall, the drug of choice in all cases has now become, for both type 1 and type 2 lepra reaction, is corticosteroids. Now overall, the drug of choice for lepra reaction has become corticosteroids. Okay, and which corticosteroid we use? Most commonly we use prednisolone in the dose of 1 mg/kg. Okay, this is the drug of choice for both type of lepra reaction, type 1 as well as type 2 lepra reaction. But we know that type 2 lepra reaction is more dangerous. Remember, only in type 2 lepra reaction now, which is the very dangerous type of lepra reaction, you'll write not in 1. Only in type 2 lepra reaction, you will write this corticosteroid resistant cases. If the corticosteroid is unable to reduce the inflammation, then the drug of choice is, you will add thalidomide. In corticosteroid resistant cases, you will add a drug thalidomide. Okay, thalidomide is also an anti-inflammatory. It inhibits TNF-alpha. It inhibits TNF-alpha. Now the point is, when we start corticosteroid and then we withdraw this corticosteroid, suddenly what happens? Due to corticosteroid withdrawal, again lepra reaction can precipitate. So sometimes there is steroid dependent cases. There is steroid dependence also. In steroid dependence cases, the drug of choice is clofazimine. Clofazimine is the drug of choice for steroid dependent cases. Okay, steroid dependent cases. And you must remember that MDT, multi-drug therapy, should not be stopped. Should not be stopped in lepra reaction. We must continue all the drugs. Now the point comes, why we are using clofazimine. Remember, clofazimine is also anti-inflammatory molecule. It also has anti-inflammatory, and it reduces the immunity of the body. Hence, because of this reason, it will inhibit this hypersensitivity condition. Okay, so this is the treatment of lepra reaction. The drug of choice is corticosteroid. In corticosteroid resistant cases of type 2 lepra reaction, drug of choice is thalidomide. So how to remember thalidomide? Thalidomide means T means type, DO word is coming. So thalidomide is only given in type 2 lepra reaction. DO means DO. Okay, so try to remember, it is not given in type 1 lepra reaction. So let's talk about these drugs for leprosy and their details. Okay, so the first drug we will write in leprosy is Dapsone. Okay, Dapsone. Now what is the mechanism of action of Dapsone? Remember, Dapsone is a sulfonamide. It is also known as sulfone. Okay, and we know that sulfonamide, they inhibit folate synthase enzyme. Hence, it inhibits folic acid synthesis in a bacteria. okay, folic acid synthesis in a bacteria. Now, how it is given? Root, Dapsone is given orally, daily, and unsupervised, not under supervision. So rest other drugs are given under supervision. Okay. Now we have made a new form of Dapsone that is known as Acidapsone. Acidapsone, remember, is given as an intramuscular injection. Okay, and it act for 3 months. It act for 3 months. So it is given once a 3 month. It is given once a 3 month. Okay, Acidapsone. Now let's see the uses of Dapsone. Now Dapsone, it is used in certain infections, and it is the oldest drug for leprosy, and it is still considered as a drug of choice for leprosy. And it was the oldest drug also. It was the first drug we made for leprosy. Okay, but apart from leprosy, Dapsone is also used in certain other infections like pneumocystis, Jeroveci infection. But remember, it is not the drug of choice for pneumocystis jeroveci. The drug of choice is cotrimoxazole for the treatment of pneumocystis jeroveci, for both treatment and prevention. You will write, it is also given in, so how to remember? You can write a mnemonic, leave PMT. You will write leave PMT. So M stands for Madura mycosis, which is also known as Madura foot, which is caused by actinomycosis. Okay. Lastly, you will write, it is also given in Toxoplasma gondii infection. It is effective here also. Now, apart from them, which is a mnemonic leave PMT, Dapsone is also given in dermatology on certain skin conditions. Okay, in which skin condition? You will write, Dapsone is a drug of choice for dermatitis, herpetiformis. It is given as a topical drug for dermatitis herpetiformis. This skin lesion is seen in a disease known as celiac sprue or gluten sensitive enteropathy. It is used there, the skin lesion. Okay, so this is expected from you, that Dapsone is the drug of choice for dermatitis herpetiformis. Just for your reference, you can write, Dapsone can also be given in other skin condition as well. Okay, so it can also be given in acne vulgaris as a topical drug. It is also given in pemphigoid lesions or bullous skin lesion, when the bullae on the skins are formed. It is also given in linear IgA disease. Okay, it is also given in relapsing polychondritis. And lastly, it is also given in brown recluse spider ulcer. So remember, these things are just for your reference only. But what is expected from you is this one, dermatitis herpetiformis. So for your exams and most of the clinical part, you must remember the word dermatitis herpetiformis. These options are just for your reference. The Dapsone has some other uses as well. So keeping this thing in mind, let's see the side effects of Dapsone. Okay, the most common side effect of Dapsone is hemolytic anemia. Hemolytic anemia is the most common side effect of Dapsone. And remember, this hemolytic anemia, it occurs in all patients who are receiving, in all patients who receive Dapsone. So it is the most common side effect. Second, you will write, it also causes hypersensitivity, because It is a sulfa-containing drug, and any drug which contains sulfa causes hypersensitivity. Hence, it is also contraindicated in sulfa allergy. Now, which hypersensitivity you will write? Most common hypersensitivity which is seen is rashes. On skin, there could be lichenoid eruption. And on blood, sometimes a dangerous agranulocytosis can occur. Now, what is agranulocytosis? A means not happening. Granulocytosis is not happening. So, the granulocyte number decreases. Decrease in number of WBC like granulocyte like neutrophil. And lastly, it may also cause infectious mononucleosis, which could be very dangerous. Okay. Infectious mononucleosis. And last point is dapsone is absolutely contraindicated in G6PD enzyme deficiency. Okay. It is a sulfa containing drug, and sulfonamide are absolutely contraindicated in glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency because it will lead to hemolytic anemia, hemolysis. Okay, absolutely contraindicated. Now, the next drug we have is clofazimine. Okay. Now, what is the mechanism of action of clofazimine as a drug? Remember, the exact mechanism of action of clofazimine is still not known, but remember, it inhibits cell membrane. Okay, it inhibits or damages the cell membrane. Now, the second point you must write that clofazimine has anti-inflammatory property. That means it reduces the immunity of the body. Why? It directly inhibits macrophages and T cells, and they will not able to act. Because of this reason, remember, clofazimine must be used in steroid dependent lepra reaction. Okay? Because of this reason, it was used in steroid dependent lepra reaction, and it must be given always with in dapsone allergy patients or dapsone hypersensitivity patient. If a dapsone is producing allergic reaction, clofazimine must be given always because it will have anti-leprosy property as well as it will reduce the allergic reactions of dapsone. Okay, now let's see the side effect of clofazimine. Before that, what is the uses? Remember, clofazimine is given in both TB and leprosy. It is given in both TB and leprosy. In TB, it is an approved drug for MDR-TB, that is multi-drug resistance TB. Okay. Now, you will write that what are the side effects of clofazimine. If you talk about the history of clofazimine was before becoming as an anti-leprosy drug, it was used as a coloring dye in textile industry. Okay, now keeping this thing in mind, remember, clofazimine causes color abnormality and it causes its crystal deposit in GIT. Okay, in intestine, the crystals of clofazimine gets deposited. Now, what coloring abnormality? You will write, it causes discoloration of skin, which may look like a fish skin known as ichthyosis. Okay, it causes discoloration of hair, it causes discoloration of cornea, conjunctiva in eye. And it also causes discoloration of body secretions like tears, sweat, saliva, urine, etc. Okay, but remember the main side effect of clofazimine is coloring abnormality. It causes color abnormality. Remember, these coloring abnormalities are not seen with no discoloration of skin. It is not seen with Dapsone. Dapsone does not cause discoloration or coloring abnormality. It is not seen with Dapsone. Pigmentation of skin, pigmentation of hair, cornea, etc. So coloring abnormality is a side effect of clofazimine, not of Dapsone. Now, when the crystals of clofazimine gets deposited in GIT, it leads to diarrhea, severe diarrhea. And it may lead to ulcers due to damage of intestine. And sometimes it can lead to subacute bowel obstruction. They may obstruct the bowel. And it could be very dangerous. Subacute bowel obstruction. Okay. So when the crystals will get deposited in GIT, it leads to diarrhea, ulcer and subacute bowel obstruction. Okay. So this is about the drug. So rifampicin we have already covered, other drugs we have already covered in tuberculosis. Okay, so for rifampicin, please refer tuberculosis part. We have discussed rifampicin in great detail. So this is all about leprosy. Now the next bacteria after leprosy, you'll write is other mycobacterias. Other mycobacterias. Let's see the treatment of other mycobacterias. So the first mycobacteria you will write is MAC. MAC stands for Mycobacterium avium complex. Okay. Now which infection this Mycobacterium avium complex causes? Mycobacterium avium complex causes pneumonias. Okay, pneumonias. Now this group Mycobacterium avium complex, it has two types of mycobacteria in it. The one is known as Mycobacterium avium. MIC stand for Mycobacterium avium. And second we have is Mycobacterium intracellulare. Okay, so these are the two species of mycobacteria we have in cases of MAC. Okay, now this Mycobacterium avium and Mycobacterium intracellularly, they cause pneumonia. This avium, it causes pneumonia in HIV patients. In HIV patient, when the CD4 count of patient falls less than 50 per millimeter cube, so it causes in immunocompromised people. Okay, intracellulare may cause in normal people also, without HIV people. Okay, let's see what are the drugs we have for the treatment for MAC, Mycobacterium avium treatment. The drugs for the treatment, you will write a mnemonic, CARE. CARE. Okay, so C stand for clarithromycin. Instead of clarithromycin, you can also give azithromycin. These two drugs are found to be effective. Now, instead of rifampicin, you will write rifabutin. And one anti-tubercular drug, ethambutol. Okay, ethambutol. Now, if there is still no response, still there is a resistance or no response, we can add fluoroquinolones. We can add fluoroquinolones or aminoglycosides. Okay. Now the fluoroquinolones which are approved are, you will write ciprofloxacin, levofloxacin, and the third one which has been approved is moxifloxacin. Okay. Among aminoglycoside, you can give injection of, it is the only injectable drug, of streptomycin or emicasin. Okay, this is the drugs we have for treatment. Now the drugs for prevention. Prevention or prophylaxis means the patient is still not having MAC infection, but the patient is at high risk of acquiring it. So prophylaxis of MAC or prevention we start when the patient's CD4 count is less than 50 in HIV and still the patient has not acquired MAC infection. The drug of choice for prevention of MAC or prophylaxis of MAC is azithromycin. Or you can use rifabutin. This is a very important question for you. Azithromycin, remember, is given once a week. Rifabutin is given daily. Okay? So for prevention, either we use azithro or rifabutin. For treatment, we use care. Okay? And in resistance cases, fluoroquinolone and aminoglycoside. Now what about intracellulare? The treatment of intracellulare is absolutely same. But remember, instead of rifabutin, here rifampicin is more preferred as compared to rifabutin. Okay, so what is the difference between rifampicin and rifabutin? We will discuss shortly in this section only. Okay, so this is about MAC infection. So this is expected from you. Now just for your reference, you will write other mycobacterias. Okay, other mycobacterias. Okay, apart from TB and leprosy. So these are just for your reference. So first you will write Mycobacterium kensasi. Kensasi. Okay, here the drug of choice is a combination of isoniazid, rifampicin, and ethambutol. Okay, second you will write Mycobacterium fortuitum complex. Here the treatment is amikacin plus doxycycline. Amikacin plus doxycycline. Third, you will write Mycobacterium marinum. Okay, here you will write rifampicin and ethambutol. So these are just for your reference. They are very unlikely that they will be asked from you. Okay, but to complete your notes, you must write Mycobacterium ulcerans. Okay, you'll write rifampicin plus streptomycin. But remember, the main treatment of Mycobacterium ulcerans is surgery. The main treatment is surgery. Remove that part of skin. Next, you will write Mycobacterium abscessus. Abscessus. You'll write Mycobacterium malmonse. And Mycobacterium haemophyllum. So these are the species of different atypical forms of mycobacteria. You'll write in abscesses, the drug of choice is cefoxitin, which is a second generation cephalosporin, or you can use imipenem, which is a carbapenem. Okay, add amikacin. And add to amikacin clarithromycin. Okay, malmoxy, you will write rifampicin plus ethambutol. Plus clarithromycin. And lastly, Mycobacterium haemophyllum, you'll write rifampicin, fluoroquinolone, and clarithromycin. Okay, so this is the treatment of other mycobacteria. These are just for your references. Okay, now before ending this chapter, let's see what are the different types of rifampicin, rifabutin, these drugs. Let's write a group of these drugs. A very important class of drug we have is where rifampicin is placed and rifabutin is placed. That very important class of drug is rifamycins. Rifamycins. So among rifamycins, we have various drugs. Remember, rifamycins, they inhibit DNA dependent. This word is important, RNA polymerase. This is their mechanism of action, and they are given mainly in mycobacteria. Now just remember, these drugs, they are orange to red color drug. Their color is orange to red color. Okay, so what is their color? Orange to red color drug. Okay, now let's see what are the drugs we have among rifamycins. Let's see what are the drugs we have. The first drug you will write is rifampicin. Here you will write rifabutin. Okay, now rifampicin is the mainstay of treatment of TB and leprosy. Rifabutin is the mainstay of the treatment of MAC infections. Okay, the rifampicin is mainly given in TB leprosy. Rifabutin is mainly given in MAC infection. Now, if you talk about pharmacokinetic, rifampicin is a very potent enzyme inducer. It induces various CYP enzyme. It is liver toxic or hepatotoxic, and rifampicin is a very short acting drug. Now, as compared to rifampicin, we compare rifampicin with rifabutin. Rifabutin has a very low enzyme induction property. Because of this reason, it is more easy to combine rifabutin with other drug. Okay, it is more preferred to be combined with other drug. Combined easily with other drugs. Okay, you'll write it is liver safe. And lastly, it is long acting as compared to rifampicin. Okay, it is longer acting. So this is the advantage of using rifabutin. Now, what is the side effect of rifampicin? Rifampicin causes orange to red colored urine. Orange, red color urine, because it is excreted out in urine. Rifabutin, you will write that rifabutin, it causes orange to red color skin. Orange to red color skin, because it gets deposited in skin. So if the skin will become orangish, it will look like a jaundice patient. This condition is known as pseudo jaundice. It is also known as pseudo jaundice. So you will look like that the patient is suffering from jaundice. Okay, so rifabutin causes pseudo jaundice. This is a very important question. Because of orange red color skin, it can also cause polymyalgia. It can also cause panuveitis, which could be dangerous. But what is expected from you is pseudo jaundice is caused by rifabutin. Okay, now let's write other drugs. You'll write rifapentin, and the next drug is rifaximin. Now rifapentin is a new drug for TB. But remember, it is not used in India. Okay, rifaximin, it is used in three conditions. You will write HIT. The first condition is known as hepatic encephalopathy, to kill the bacteria in GIT which are forming ammonia, because ammonia is dangerous in liver failure. Okay, here it is the drug of choice. Okay, rifaximin. You can also use one another neo antibiotic known as neomycin to kill GIT bacteria. Okay, I stand for, it is also given in irritable bowel syndrome. Okay, and rifaximin is also given in traveler's diarrhea. Traveler's diarrhea. But remember, the drug of choice for traveler's diarrhea is not rifaximin, it is fluoroquinolones like ciprofloxacin, etc. Okay, so this is all about the uses of rifamycins. Okay, so thank you very much for listening.